Hello everyone. I'm G and the first chapter will experience the features of from modeling. And you will know the fun of Fusion 360 from modeling. Let's have fun together. For the first user, select the help menu in the upper right corner. Then select Fusion 360 API from the pull-down menu. You can check here for an overview of the application programming interface. In this chapter, you will experience the features of form modeling in practice. The first step is to set up the view cube. Click the icon at the bottom right of the view. In my case, select perspective with ortho faces in the drop-down menu. You can change the view by selecting the view cube, like this. Get started with form modeling. Select the Create Form icon from the toolbar. The toolbar changes to display and form modeling tools. Okay, let's create an object. Get started with form modeling. Select box from create in the toolbar. And then, set up the object. First, select the work plane on which you want to set the object. Second, snap the cursor to the center. Third, click and drag. And fifth, click to create an object. It may not work in the beginning. Try practicing a few times. Let's practice again. Select box from the toolbar. Select a work plane. Then, snap the cursor to the center. And click drag to create an object. Next, let's set the size of the object. You can click and move the arrow to resize it. And you can select and move this icon to set the segment of the edge. I recommend that entry users be set numerically in the option box. Key in the number of lengths, widths, and heights. Then, control the size of the corner R by the number of faces. Decreasing the number of faces makes the corner R softer. Conversely, if you increase the number of faces, the corner R will be smaller. When the size is confirmed, press OK to finish. Well, let's talk about editing objects. Select box from the toolbar to create an object like this. Key in 100 for length, width, and height in option box. Leave the number of faces. Setting symmetry. Select the drop-down menu of symmetry. And select the mirror. Then, the target settings menu will be displayed. Check the option box in which direction to set the target and try. As you can see, a green line appears when the target is set. The mirror has been set for this green line. Press OK when you are done. Display mode. Form modeling has three pattern display modes, so I will explain. Select a face like this, and right-click on the mouse. Then, you can see the edit form menu. Take a look at the display mode. Here you can see the mode of three patterns. Shortcut menu is Alt plus 1 in box mode. Smooth mode is Alt plus 3. I usually use these two patterns to switch. There are four object selection filters, vertex, edge, face, and all. Normally, I'm selecting all mode. Let's actually select. W-click an edge, like this, and the edge will be selected in a loop. Then, select the first edge and shift the last edge and press W-click, to select all intermediate edges as well. Vertex as a face is the same. When you select an object, the manipulator appears. In this manipulator, you will continue to perform edits. Extrude. Select several faces. Mirror symmetry is set, so the opposite side is automatically selected. Right-click to display the edit form. Select the up arrow, and try moving it up. Then, the shape changes like this. Reset object once, with Ctrl plus Z. So next, try holding Alt, and moving the arrow upward. And then, another volume will be extrude like this. Then move the arrow upward again. Do not press Alt at this time. If you press Alt again, a segment is created and a new volume is generated. Let's check smooth display, with Alt plus 3. How to select objects efficiently? You can select objects one by one. Or multiple objects at the same time. If you click and drag the cursor from left to right, a yellow selection area appears like this. And objects touching this yellow area will be selected. Conversely, if you click and drag from left to right, the selection is displayed in orange. In this case, you must have all objects in the selection range to be selected. The sides are not visible from the front, but they are all included in the selection area so they can be selected. Now let's practice. Click and drag left to right to select objects touching the selection. This is the selection method you need for car modeling. When selected this way, only the side edges are selected. Run this selection method consecutively. In this way, you can quickly adjust the silhouette. The fun part of form modeling is the tension control. If you understand its characteristics, you will be able to control it at your disposal. For example, select the top face, right-click, and select Delete. You can also delete it by the backspace key. Alt plus 3 to make it smooth. As you can see, The tension was released with the removal of the top side. As a result, the shape changed in this way. Next, try deleting the side faces. You can see that the edges of the area are pulled to the center with this removed. Try extruding a new volume from the deleted edge. Double-click an edge. Right-click and select Form Edit. Select the horizontal arrow of the manipulator and hold Alt to move it. And once Alt is released, again holding Alt and moving the arrow creates a segment like this. Let's adjust the details of the shape. Select edges like this. Right-click to select Edit Form. Select the arrow and move it like this, do not press Alt at this time. When you can adjust the URL, hold Alt and move the arrow to create a new volume. When you're done, press OK. Try practicing the front as well. Let's set the mirror symmetry back and front. Select Mirror Internal from the Symmetry drop-down menu, on the toolbar. Then, when you select the target face, the center line turns green. So let's practice in the same way. Delete the selected faces after extruding the new volume. And then extrude the new volume after adjusting the radius. The big difference between surface modeling and form modeling can be intuitively modeled like clay. Please experience this feeling first. The operation of form modeling is not difficult, but it requires practice to control tension. Please practice a lot to learn the sense of tension control. Quick rendering. Save the file first. Select Render from the workspace at the top left. Select Appearance from the toolbar. There are many materials in the library. When setting a material, you can assign the selected material to an object by drag and drop it. Select Scene Settings from the toolbar. Select the Environment Library tab from the Scene Settings menu. You can choose several HDRs like this. Double-click the target HDR to set it. HDR with a download icon is in the cloud. So please download it and set it. Select the Settings tab. Then select the Position icon to display the slider. You can adjust the position of the shadow with this arrow. And you can rotate the HDR with the slider. The position of the light can be adjusted by rotation. Select 16 to 9 from the aspect ratio drop-down menu. Select an in-canvas render from the toolbar, then you can see ray tracing rendering. Select the render tab. Select 16 to 9 from the aspect ratio drop-down menu. Next, choose either cloud rendering or local rendering. If you use cloud rendering, you will need credits like this. Select local render this time. Okay, let's do the rendering. When rendering starts, an icon appears in the rendering gallery like this, and you can check the progress. Click the icon when the rendering is complete. Then, click on the download icon to download the finished rendering. Thank you for watching. This time I explained the points of form modeling. The next chapter will send you a modeling series for 5 minutes. Let's learn the basic operation for car modeling.